You should get to know more about animals, about wildlife, about our ecosystem. In fact, we would like to know more about our ecosystem on the basis of some trivias that we are sharing in this quiz. So that's it. We'll begin without any more delay. So these are your rules. So overall, we have 32 questions plus 10 for every correct answer. No negatives in any case. Participants have to write their answers in the chat box with the option Aniruddha Morarka. You don't have to give out the answer by unmuting yourself or raise your hand or anything like that. Just make sure you're writing your answers on the chat box with the option Aniruddha Morarka so that the other participants are not able to see each other's answers. Multiple attempts from the same participants are allowed, so feel free to guess. For every question, only the first three correct answers shall be considered. So the first three answers that reach us at this particular chat box, we'll be giving points to only those people. And again, the most important rule, participants are requested to refrain from using the internet to get towards the answer because you will be spoiling the fun if you choose to do that. So we'll begin. Is everybody ready? Please share your thumbs up.
So can we send multiple answers?
Yeah, you can send multiple answers, but make sure they are one after the other, not at the same time.
What is the time limit?
Our time limit depends upon the length of the question, and it depends on the quiz master. But what matters most is the first three correct answers get the points, irrespective of what the time limit is. Okay, so we'll begin with the first question. Is everybody ready? Question number
Yes,
one.
sir.
Sorry.
Yes, sir, we are ready.
Okay, and please mute yourself. If you need any clarity or something, you can use the text box. And I hope I'm audible to all of you. So
Yes, sir.
question number one, and please answer only after I finish reading out the question, not before that. Question number one, Himalayan forest thrush is one of the latest bird species to be discovered in India. Its scientific name is Zoothera X, thus being one of the few birds to be named after Indians. You have to identify this Indian X. You can see the bird over here. It's commonly called Himalayan forest thrush, and it's named after an Indian. Zoothera X, X being the name of that famous Indian. So the answers have started to flow in. Okay, so the three people who get it right are Yukta Singh, Ayush Kumar Jha, and Rohan Bell. The correct answer is indeed Dr. Salim Ali. Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan passed away in 1987, still known as the Birdman of India. Okay, most of you answered Kipling. Kipling is not correct. Moving on to question number two. This is not restricted to wildlife, it's about a bird. The X chickens are a smaller variety of chicken, which is nearly one third the size of a normal chicken breed. Named after the city of X in Java, these chicken breeds have lent their names to several other fields. During the First World War, the British Army raised battalions where the minimum height recruitment was reduced from 5 feet 3 inches to 5 feet. The soldiers thus recruited were called as Xs. The term X is also a class or a category in several combat sports. Identify X. Like in the sport of boxing or judo, you might find a particular category called this is the X category. That X is basically the name of this chicken, and it also happens to be the name of a city in Java. Identify X. So 5 feet 3 inch was a standard recruitment height for the British Army, but owing to the shortage of soldiers, they had reduced the same to 5 feet. And the soldiers who were recruited because of that, they were nicknamed as Xs. What is X? We have received one answer so far. We'll wait for a bit long. Boxing is the most crucial clue here. In boxing, judo, or in most of the combat sports, you would have heard this particular term. Okay, we'll have to close. The answer is bantams. So bantam weight is the common word which we hear in combat sports. And bantam happens to be the name of this particular chicken breed and also a city in Java. So we just have one correct answer here. That is Rohan Behel. Great answer, Rohan Behel. Only Rohan Behel gets 10 points. Nobody else. Moving on. Again, not restricted to wildlife. This is a question on botany or politics. India had faced a severe food crisis in the year 1955. It was a time where the whole world was still recovering from the losses of the Second World War. In order to avoid food shortage, India signed the famous PL-480 deal with the US government, where US dumped the poor quality wheat, which they felt was unfit for their own people, in India. This wheat was later proven to be unhealthy. However, with this PL-480 wheat, it is believed that a wheat named Paranthium hystrophoros made its entry in India. This wheat proved to be even more dangerous than the PL-480 wheat, as it had the tendency to create health hazards to the people. Within a short time, it spread like wildfire, not only creating public nuisance, but also spreading hazards like hay fever, asthma, etc. Many scientists described it as poisonous, allergic, and aggressive wheat, posing a serious threat to human beings and livestock. However, the stand of US is that it existed in India even before the PL-480 deal. This wheat is now known as X. The name would seem to be a protest of some sort from the people. You have to identify X. In short, when this deal was signed, along with wheat, they sent something extra, and it created a big trouble for Indians, everybody in India, even the livestock. And today we know this particular wheat by a different name, which is some sort of protest from people. What is the name of this wheat? And we have three answers ready. Let's check out the answer. It is Congress grass. Three people who get it right are Jairaj Joshi, Romil Mahajan, and Ahamdev Bhattacharya. Great answer. So Congress grass is not its official name. It's basically a nickname. And we find it everywhere. Almost every area, every single area, we can get to see a lot of Congress grass. So three people who get it right are, once again, Ahamdev, Jairaj, and Romil. Moving on. Question number four. The wood of Aquilaria trees are probably one of the most costliest in the world today, with its cost varying from $1,000 to $10,000 per kg. What makes this wood so costly is a parasite which attacks these trees and adds value to its wood. This infected wood, called X wood, is mentioned in the Vedas and also is highly valued in Islam, Buddhism, Taoism, and Christianity. Its extreme high value has resulted in over-harvesting and habitat loss for the trees, and they are now declared as endangered. The export of X wood is highly regulated in many parts of the world, including India. Identify X. You might not have heard the name of this particular tree or its wood, but you definitely are using one of the products made from this particular wood. That is the only clue that I can provide. And three answers are ready. So let us have a look at the answer. It is indeed agar or oud. Agarbatti, oudbatti is basically created from agar wood. And that makes this particular wood the costliest in the world. Even attars are, or many of the attars are created from oud, and they are also one of the costliest attars. Three people who get it right: Om Tajne, Rohan Behel, and Jairaj Joshi, and Pallavi Bandiwar. Not Jairaj Joshi. Once again, Om Tajne, Rohan Behel, and Pallavi Bandiwar. Great answers. Moving on. Question number 5. Ollie, a kookaburra, Sid, a platypus, and Millie, an echidna, were the mascots of the Sydney Olympics held in 2000. These animals were residents of Australia and their names were chosen this way as if they were shortened versions of Olympics, Sydney and Millennium. Platypus and echidna are the only two members of a group called monotreme. What is the specialty of monotremes? This is a group which has just two animals and all of them are present in this particular image. Okay, so we have the answer ready. So basically you have to tell me what are monotremes. The answer is mammals that can lay eggs. That is the answer. And a lot of you have answered correctly, but points to Yukta Singh, Rabia Shabbir and Ishan. Yukta Singh, Rabia Shabbir and Ishan Sarada get plus 10 each. Moving on. Panthera tigris X, commonly referred to as the Indo-Chinese tiger, is an endangered subspecies of the tiger family with just close to 350 throughout the world, primarily found in Thailand, Myanmar, and Vietnam. This tiger is named after X, a wildlife conservationist well known throughout the world. You have to identify the conservationist after whom this tiger species is named. And you already would have encountered the name more than once in the elimination round. It is indeed Jim Corbett. Three people get it right. Yukta Singh, Rohan Behel and Romil Mahajan. Get a plus 20. Plus 10. Moving on. I hope you're finding it interesting. Okay, that is one of the advantages of online quizzing. Yeah, even if you would say no, I would not know. Moving on, question number 7. The XT is a type of tea cultivated in mountains of Yan, China. The tea is primarily fertilized by the dung of X, which also lends its name to the tea, thus making it very similar to the Kopi Luwak. You would have heard about Kopi Luwak in the eliminations. When the tea was officially launched by its inventor An Yanshi, 50 grams of this tea was sold for $3,500. Making it the world's most expensive tea. Even today, the tea holds this record. X is considered to have medicinal properties and encourages the culture of recycling and using organic fertilizers. Identify X. So we have three answers ready instantly. It is indeed panda. Panda's dung is used to fertilize this particular tea, and that's what makes it an exotic item in everybody's bucket list, I suppose. So three people who get it right are Yukta Singh, Ayush Kumar Jha, and Rabia Shabbir. Question number 8. Again, mythology here. According to Hindu mythology, the chariot of Krishna is driven by this animal and hence is also called as Krishnamrig. It is also considered to be the vehicle of Som, Vayu, and Chandra. ID this famous animal, which is also the state animal of Andhra Pradesh. And you would find this animal's name mentioned in entertainment column of the newspapers for some other reasons. And we have the three answers ready. It is indeed the black buck. People who get the points, Yukta Singh scoring consistently, Rohan Behel and Ayush Kumar Jha. Moving on. Question number 9. Passion flower or passiflora is a flower with nearly 500 varieties and found in most parts of the world. One of the most common features of this flower is its 100 petals of one color and 5 anthers of a different color above it. The most common one found in India has 100 violet petals and 5 yellow anthers. Although in Hindi, it's called Krishna Kamal, by what other Hindi name do we know this flower? 100 violet petals and 5 yellow anthers. Participants answering instantly. Do we have the three answers? 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So we do have three answers ready. It is indeed Kaurav Pandav Vlar and Pallavi Bandivar, Rabia Shabir and Jaira Joshi get plus 10 each. Great answers. 100 violet petals and 5 anthers make it Kaurav Pandav Vlar. Its official name, however, is Krishna Kamal. Question number 10. X is a type of a dinosaur believed to have existed in the Indian subcontinent, the remains of which were excavated from the Narmada River Valley in the Kheda district of Gujarat. After years of excavation, which involved many Indian scientists and geologists, X was formally described in 2003, its name meaning kingly lizard. Identify X. A lot of answers coming in. Okay, let's have a look at the answer. It is indeed Rajasaurus. Okay, we'll consider Maharajasaurus too. Okay, Yukta Singh gets a plus 10. Ishan Sarda gets a plus 10. And Ayush Kumar Jha gets a plus 10. Yukta Singh, Ishan Sarda and Ayush Kumar Jha. Question number 11. The Silent Valley National Park, located in Nilgiri Hills, was discovered by botanist Robert White in 1847. By discovered, I mean nobody knew such a place existed before 1847 until Robert White arrived. The national park is like any other jungle, full of animals and noise due to the presence of animals and insects. Then why is the national park called Silent Valley? It has enough animals, enough insects, and it's as noisy as every other national park. But it is called Silent Valley for a particular reason. What is that reason? And we have answers ready. Let us have a look. The absence of cicada. Cicada is one particular insect which makes the highest frequency of sound. And that insect is absent or was absent in this particular place. That's why it's called Silent Valley. So three people who get it right are Yukta Singh, Ishan Sarda and Ayush Kumar Jha. Same as earlier, Yukta Singh, Ishan Sarda and Ayush Kumar Jha get a plus 10 each. We'll have a look at the scores. Yukta Singh 70 points, Ishan Sarda 30, Rohan Behel is at 50, Rabia Shabir is at 30, Ahmedev is at 10, Ayush Jha is at 50, Jaira Joshi is at 20, Pallavi is at 20, Om Tajne is at 10, Dakshata 20, Romil Mahajan 20, and the others will be scoring soon. Moving on. Question number 12. X tree is a native of the Himalayas, Tibet, China, and many parts of the Indian subcontinent. X derives its name from the Sanskrit meaning wood of the gods. In Hindu mythology, it is said that Parvati raised this tree as her child. X is mentioned several times in Ramayana as well. X also happens to be the national tree of Pakistan. Which is this tree? The key word here is wood of the gods. If you translate the same into Sanskrit, you will arrive at X. And X is also the national tree of Pakistan. So the three people who get it right are Rabia Shabir, Ayush Kumar Jha, and Sachin Banerjee. Sanchari Banerjee. So I'd like to request you not to use Google or any other electronic form to reach out to the answer, because the fun will be spoiled if you do that. You can enjoy the trivia here and try to use your brains, work out the answer. There are enough clues provided here everywhere. So you can reach out towards the answer and work it out. Question number 13. The answer is indeed Devdaru or Devdar. Food of the gods.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, actually, I also sent the answer.
Okay.
Sir, I also.
Yeah, everybody sent us the correct answer. But the first three people who sent the answer are getting the points as mentioned in the instructions.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Moving on. Question number 13. The animal X is mentioned in some versions of Mahabharata. According to these stories, Lord Krishna introduced X as animals to be used in battle, but the plan was abandoned since X did not obey commands. X is mentioned in the Rig Veda, which speaks of its body, and in early Buddhist literature, an entire sutra is written in X's name, which speaks about the values of renunciation. X is the Vahan of goddess Dhavadi, and X was often confused with a mythical animal due to one major similarity between that mythical animal and X. What animal are we talking about? Vahan of the goddess Dhavadi, mentioned in the Rig Veda, and an entire sutra is mentioned in Buddhism, speaking about the value of renunciation, because this animal is primarily a solitary animal. Do we have the answers? Yes. So let us have a look at the answer. It is indeed rhinoceros, and the mythical animal is unicorn. Many European explorers thought unicorns existed in India, but the historical explanation provided to it is they might have encountered rhinoceros because of the similar feature. So the three people who get points are Sanchari Banerjee. Aryan Yadav and Pallavi Bandevan. One second. Sanchari Banerjee, Rohan Behl, and Aryan Yadav. Once again, Rohan Behl, Sanchari Banerjee, and Aryan Yadav. These three people get plus 10. Most of you have answered it correctly. Only these three people get a plus 10. Moving on. Question number 14. X-spotting or X-ing refers to the little spots of char that occur on the rim of a pizza that are sometimes large and sometimes pinprick size. X-ing is a subset of charring, another famous technique, and is a result of fermentation bubbles that shows that the dough was properly proofed. The question is, why would this cooking technique be a part of a wildlife quiz? Something to do with the spots. X-spotting or X-ing. That's what they are called. And the spots are sometimes as large as shown in the image, and sometimes they are very small. And we have the answers. The answer is indeed a leopard spotting, because of similarity of leopard spots with those shown in the image. And the three people who get the points are Rabia Shabbir, Ahemdev, and Rohan Behl. Rabia Shabbir, Ahemdev, and Rohan Behl get a plus 10 each. Question number 15. The phrase X, meaning superficial sympathy, is believed to be first used by Plutarch in the first century. A theological twist was given to the phrase by Saint Photios the Great to illustrate the Christian concept of repentance. The phrase gained popularity in English language only after Sir John Mandeville mentioned about the same in his work, Travels with Sir John Mandeville. Scientists state that there is no truth in the phrase, and in reality, it is just a method of getting rid of excessive salt taken in a normal diet. But despite of this, the phrase is now a part of Hindi and most of the other languages in the world, commonly used in movies and TV serials. In fact, it's inseparable from Hindi TV serials. Almost in every single episode, you might be encountering this particular phrase. What is this phrase? So what we mean here is scientists have proved that whatever is mentioned in the phrase, it's not true. And the reason why this occurs is because it is the method of getting rid of excessive salt taken in normal diet. What is the phrase? So we have three answers ready. It is indeed magarmach ke aansu or tears of a crocodile. A crocodile does not do it deliberately to catch attention as claimed by the phrase, but it does it to get rid of the excess salt which it has intaken. So the three people who get points are Ahemdev, Rabia and Rohan Bell. Moving on. Question number 16. As per a Quranic verse, the children of Adam, the first man to be sent on earth, Kabil and Habil, known as Cain and Abel, had a dispute amongst themselves owing to their marriage to each other's twin sisters. Kabil killed Habil, but couldn't decide what to do with the dead body and was guilt-ridden. So God sent a group of exes on the earth. These exes quarreled amongst themselves, resulting in one of them to kill the other and subsequently bury it. This act gave Kabil the idea to bury the body of his brother and flee, which is from where the concept of burying the dead came to be. Coincidentally, a group of exes is also called murder. Identify X. We could have avoided the last line, but that is what makes the entire quiz workable. If you just know this one particular fact, a group of exes is called a murder, then you will be able to reach out to the answer. And the extra information would be something new you would have learned today. So do we have the answers? Okay, we do have three answers. The answer is indeed crows. A group of crow is called murder. And three people who get it right are Yukta Singh, Rohan Behel and Ishan Sarda. Plus 10 each. Moving on. Slightly difficult over here. Fennec foxes, also known as X, are one of the smallest subspecies of foxes, which are known for its acute hearing sense, as you can see from those ears, found primarily in the Sahara Desert and other parts of North Africa. These foxes are very popular as an exotic pet in many parts of the world, not legally, of course. Despite of being simple creatures who rarely do any harm to humans, its alternate name, X, was once a very feared name in the continent nearly 70 years ago, owing to someone else. What is X? And you don't have to give me the second part. Why was the name feared? By what nickname do we know fennec foxes? And there was a historical figure 70 years ago who had this particular nickname, and that was the reason the name was very feared in Africa. We have two answers so far. Okay. Okay, we do have three answers. We still have two answers. And people are giving me the biological name of this particular foxes. Am I to believe you that you know the biological name of fennec foxes? Like when you type fennec foxes in Google, the first thing that comes to Google, you're pasting it over there. It's not cool. It's really not cool. It's really not cool. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we have three answers ready. Okay, we only have two answers ready here. The answer is indeed a desert fox. And Erwin Rommel, the Nazi general, he was known as desert fox for his activities in Africa and was one of the most feared generals of his time. That was the answer we were looking forward to. And the two people who get it right are Rohan Behel and Ayush Kumar Jha. Once again, requesting you guys, please don't Google and please don't spoil the fun. We have been doing this since long and we do understand the Googlers easily. We don't want to embarrass you. That's why we are asking you not to do it. Moving on. Question number 18. The reintroduction of X in Yellowstone National Park is often seen as one of the biggest success stories. X was last seen at Yellowstone in 1925 and were reintroduced after 70 years. X's comeback halted the rapid increase of the elks, which had resulted in reduced vegetation. Improved vegetation resulted in the arrival of more birds and also beavers, who in turn provided habitat to otters, muskrats, several fishes and reptiles. X had further kept the population of coyotes under control, which improved the presence of foxes, badgers, weasels, hawks and eagles. With more berry plants, the population of bears improved too, which further kept the elks under control. The regenerated vegetation reduced soil erosion and eventually resulted in change of the flowing pattern of rivers. Thus, the presence of X resulted in entire change of Yellow National Park's ecosystem. You have to identify X. The place was not the same earlier, but after the arrival of X's, you could see that so much of vegetation and so many new species came to be a part of Yellowstone National Park. And it's often seen as a success video, successful activity done by a forest department. In fact, this video was uploaded by Yellowstone National Park themselves, and it's now a very viral video. The answer is, we do have three answers ready. The answer is wolves. And three people who get it right are Yukta Singh, Rohan Behl, and Anuja Alkari. Yukta Singh, Rohan Behl, and Anuja Alkari get a plus 10 each. Question number 19. Zawalski's horse, commonly known as the Mongolian wild horse, is a rare and endangered horse native to Central Asia. At one time, extinct in the world, it had been recently reintroduced to its natural habitat, largely due to continuous conservation efforts that have taken place since the late 1970s. During one such program in the 90s, European researchers released several dozen horses in X, a place highly unlikely to be used for horse breeding purposes. However, to everyone's surprise, X became one of the only places where the count of the horses improved, mostly due to the absence of humans in X. Apart from being the breeding grounds of Zawalski horses, X has also been serving as a de facto nature reserve, with animals like brown bears, foxes, and bisons thriving there. Identify X. So in the 90s, European researchers released these horses in a particular place. And surprisingly, due to the absence of humans over there, the numbers of these horses are flourishing. You have to identify the place. So we do have three answers ready. The place is indeed Chernobyl. In 1986, Chernobyl had to face a nuclear disaster, because of which people living there were evacuated. And it was said that nearly for 20,000 years, there would be no habitation over here. But despite of that, animals are thriving in this place even today. So this gives us an idea like how little we know about nature. There is so much that we can learn today. So that's it. So plus 10 for Priyank Dahage, Rohan Behl, and Yukta Singh. Are you enjoying the quiz? I take that as a yes. Question number 20. So there is a video attached here. The audio is not really important, so there might be difficulties in listening to the audio, but the video you all can see. We'll play that later. The text first. BBC released a trailer of their upcoming documentary hosted by Terry Jones called Miracles of Evolution in April 2008, something which was advertised as compelling evidence for Darwin's theory of evolution. The documentary focused on a set of Adélie penguins of Antarctica. To escape the extreme winter, these birds evolved with changes in their body, which allowed them to fly something which no other penguins could do. This ability they used to travel to the rainforests of South America. This trailer received millions of views, widely covered by all major newspapers, and was widely appreciated. But despite of all that, the documentary was never released even after 12 years. The trailer is still there, but the documentary isn't. What is the reason? Let's have a look at the video.
How do they use this incredible ability? Well, thousands of miles to the rainforest of South America to spend the winter basking in the tropical sun.
Okay, so that's it. You could see those beautiful penguins flying to South America, which was too good to be true. And it was a hoax. It was an April Fool prank by BBC. That's why the documentary could never be released, because it's not true. So three people who get it right are Ishan Sarda, Pallavi Bandivar, and Romil Mahajan. They get a plus 10. Moving on. And in fact, BBC has a history of having such beautiful April Fool hoaxes. If you want to know more, then you will have to participate in more of our quizzes.
Can we have scores?
Okay, we'll have scores. Yukta Singh is at 100. Ishan Sarda 50. Priyank 10. Rohan Behel is at 120. Rabia Shabir 60. Ahmedev 30. Sanjay Banerjee 20. Ayush Jha 70. Jairaj Joshi 20, Pallavi 30, Om 10, Romil 30, Aryan Yadav 10, and Anuja Alkari 10. Just a few more questions remaining. Question number 21. XYI, I because it ends from I, is a type of a jumping spider species found mostly in Central America. But unlike other spiders in their genus, the species follow a vegetarian diet. They are often known to steal food from the mouths of ants. Although there is no peculiar reason why XYI got its unique name, but researchers credit it to an author in whose honor the species was named. X being one of the most prominent characters from a book written in the 19th century, and Y being the second name of this Nobel Prize winning author who wrote this book. Identify X and Y. 19th century book. X being the character and Y being the creator. XYI is the name of this particular spider, jumping spider. Okay, the answer is indeed Bagheera Kiplingi. Bagheera being the name of the character and Rudyard Kipling, the writer. Okay, so three people who get it right are Ahmedev, Yukta Singh, and Sanchari Banerjee, plus 10 each for these three people. And almost all of you got it right. Question number 22. Let's see how many get this right. Barr-winged wren babbler is a bird found in parts of eastern India, Burma, China, and Bhutan. One of its four subspecies are found exclusively in southern Arunachal Pradesh around Nam Dhapa National Park. What makes this species unique from other subspecies is its distinct gray and brown coloring pattern. It is also probably the only bird species named in honor of an Indian political leader. Its scientific name being Spelornis troglodytes XG. ID this political leader, X. G is a clue here, and a political leader after whom a bird is named. Okay, Abhishek, you don't have to raise your hand. Just give me the name on the chat box. Barr-winged wren babbler is a bird found in the parts of eastern India. Have you received any correct answers? Okay, two answers so far. Okay, the answer is indeed Indiraji or Indira Gandhi. Three people who get, even Nam Dhapa National Park was recently named as Indira Gandhi National Park. So three people who get it right are Ishan Sarda, Anuja Alkari, and Sukrut Chaudhary. Get a plus 10 each. Question number 23. Birdman of India, Dr. Salim Ali, whom you had encountered in the first question, had suggested the name of Great Indian Bustard as the national bird of India, as he thought that this would be a positive step to create awareness about the bird. But the suggestion was ignored, as its name was very similar to an abusive word, which I won't tell you which. Today, the GIB is on the verge of extinction, with just around 150 of them worldwide. A controversial article recently claimed that the GIB was hunted down in a particular region for political reasons. The writer claimed that in this region, around 49 GIBs were killed for this particular reason in the last few years. Although the writer couldn't produce any proof for his statement, the article did make a lot of news. For what political reasons were these birds killed, according to the author? Something to do with the name. Name again. Okay, a lot of answers. The answer is indeed the article claimed Pakistanis killing the bird for having Indian in their name. So in fact, many other counter articles were written, like how wrong they were in writing the article in the first place, but it did raise a lot of controversy. So the three people who get it right are, two people gave correct answers. Ayush Kumar Jha. संचारी बैनर्जी आयुष कुमार झा संचारी बैनर्जी एंड लेट मी सी इफ एनीबडी एल्स हैज आंसर्ड एंड अभिषेक खोबरागडे सो थ्री पीपल गेट इट राइट आर अभिषेक खोबरागडे संचारी and Ayush Kumar Jha. Excellent answer by all three. Nobody else got it right. Only these three. Yeah.
Sir, actually my name is Ashwin, not Abhishek.
Your name is Ashwin. Congratulations. Abhishek, it's mentioned Abhishek Khobragade over there.
Sir, it is.
Okay, doesn't matter. 10 points to you. What's the name as said by Shakespeare? Okay, next question, question number 24. Caligula was a Roman emperor known today only for all the wrong reasons, many of which can't really be mentioned in a quiz. He was known to be a tyrant, a sadist, and a madman. His reign is often termed by historians as reign of madness. One such act of his, which he made, was when he made the young and powerful Incitatus a senator. Incitatus was an extravagant personality who had his slaves and is believed to eat gold flakes with his meals and had supreme strength. It is also believed that Caligula planned to make him the consul and also head priest in future, but Caligula was killed before he could do that. Many historians believe that this was an act of madness, and some historians say that it was a prank. What was so funny in this decision to call it madness or a prank? Like, Caligula is often called as a madman by historians, and one of the many reasons, this is one of them. He made Incitatus a senator. Incitatus, despite of being extremely healthy and having an extravagant personality, was thought to be an unfit choice by many. Lot of answers, all variety of answers, two of them correct. And we have received three answers. The answer is Incitatus was indeed a horse. In fact, many historians today, they are of the opinion that Caligula did it purposefully. He did not really share a wonderful relation with the senators. It was not like he was mad, but he wanted to show the senators their place. Like, ye toh mera ghoda bhi kar sakta hai. So that's why he nominated his horse as a senator. And people thought he was mad. Maybe he wasn't. You never know. Three people who get it right are Pallavi Bandivar, Rabia Shabbir, and Ishan Sarda. Excellent answer. Question number 25. Cable Lamjau National Park located at Loktak Lake in Bishnupur, Manipur, is the only home of the endangered Sangai deer. In 1975, Sangai was on the verge of extinction with only 14 reported numbers. It was only after the declaration of the area as national park was it possible to save this deer. Apart from being the only home of Sangai deer, Kabil Lamjau National Park is unique in the world for one other geographical feature associated with it. What feature makes this park one of its kind in the world? You might have heard of this particular place in your geography books or your GK trivia books. It's one in the world. There is no other place like this in the world for a particular geographical reason that you have to mention. Okay, we do have three answers ready. Yeah, if I were to deduct marks for spelling, then nobody would have got it right. Okay, doesn't matter. The answer is indeed the only floating national park of the world. And three people who get it right are Ayush Kumar Jha, Rabia Shabir, and Ishan Sarada. Ishan Sarada, please learn some spellings. Floating.
Sorry, sir, it was my mistake. I was in a hurry.
Okay. Moving on to question number 26. Okay, pretty interesting here. With reintroduction of cheetah in the pipeline, another suggested proposal at Kuno Palapur National Park is the introduction of X, something which has resulted in mixed reactions from ecologists. Those against the idea state that the animal X has never been a part of the Indian subcontinent and would find it difficult to adapt to Indian ecology. Plus, nowhere in the world has X ever been introduced. Those in favor say that the ancestors of X, called Brahmatherium and Shivatherium, lived on the Indian subcontinent 2.5 to 6 million years ago, and hence X's can easily adapt to India's ecology. X's carving on stone, created in the 12th century, can be found at the Sun Temple in Konark. Also, several other places like Hosambasti, Karnataka, Sushindram, Tamil Nadu, etc. And initially, European explorers mistakenly believed that India was the real home of X. It is unclear if X's would be introduced in the Indian subcontinent or not, but India is a home to nearly 30 X's which live in captivity. You have to identify the animal, X. Its ancestors, Brahmatherium and Shivatherium, lived in India, Indian subcontinent, 2.5 to 6 million years ago. And in the 12th century, some carvings were made in stone in Sun Temple and some other places depicting this particular animal. And often Europeans mistakenly believe that this animal belongs to India. But many ecologists are of the opinion that this animal won't be surviving in India because it has not been introduced to any other part in the world. What animal are we talking about? Only one correct answer so far. And I have hundreds of answers, but none of them correct except for one. Okay, we'll have to close this. Okay, so we have three answers. The answer is indeed a giraffe. As you can see here, there is this particular stone image of a giraffe along with elephant and some other animals. So three people who got it right are Sanchari Banerjee, Ahamdev Bhattacharya, and Romil Mahajan. Moving on to question number 27. The final six questions here. X is a forest species. X is a flower species found in the Shola forest of the Western Ghat. This rare plant grows at an elevation of 1300 to 2400 meters and blooms only once in 12 years. Most recently being 2018 at Iravikulam National Park in Munnar, Kerala. X, when translated from Malayalam, means blue flower. During its blooming time, most of the flowers come out together, giving the entire hills a bluish color. Nilgiri Mountains received its name from X. What is the name of X? We have one answer, two answers so far. Okay, three answers. The answer is Neelakurinji. Neelakurinji gave the name Neelgiri to Neelgiri Mountains. And this is the particular flower. So if you want to see it, you'll have to wait for 10 more years. 2030 is probably its next blooming season. And three people who get it right are Yukta Singh, Ahemdev, and Rohan Bell. Question number 28. Pretty long here, but interesting content. Akbar saw an X for the first time in 1555 when he was presented with one as a peshkash by Wali Beg, who had taken it from the Afghans after a battle. Akbar immediately developed a liking towards it and gave it a name, Fateh Baz. His liking for X's only grew with time. Soon, he developed modern ways to get hold of X, one which ensured very little injuries to it. And within a short time, Akbar maintained nearly 1,000 X, all of whom were named according to its quality and were classified into 8 classes. Please unmute, please mute your mic. Let me speak. Samanand Manik was a celebrity X in Akbar's time who had a dholi of his own and was often carried in it. Chronicles also mention about an X called Chittaranjan, whom Akbar promoted as the chief of X and was given an honor of having drums beaten every time in his presence. X's were called Yus by the Mughals. By what name do we know them now? So Akbar saw these animals for the first time in 1555 when he was given a peshkash of the same and he named it Fateh Baz. Soon he had 1,000 of these animals in his collection. Each of them were named and classified according to their skills. And one such celebrity animal is Samanand Malik, who had a dholi of his own. And when Chittaranjan arrived, drums were beaten in his honor. They were called as Yus by the Mughals. And by what name do we know them now? And we have three answers ready. Romil Mahajan, Rohan Behel, and Pallavi Vandivar. The answer is indeed cheetah. And that is probably the reason of cheetah's extinction as well. A lot of them could not breed again properly. And some really funny answers here. Okay, so moving on. Okay, question number 29. Legend has it that the poverty-stricken Taiwanese farmer found a small plant growing in his field. He was struck by its beauty and realizing that he might be able to use this to escape poverty, he decided to grow and sell these mysterious plants that were growing in this field. He soon became one of the wealthiest people in Taiwan. What plant are we talking about? This is a legend. There is no evidence regarding it, the origin of the story, but it's pretty famous and the legend is associated with that particular plant. What plant are we talking about? We all might be having this particular plant. And we have three answers ready. The answer is money plant. Yukta Singh, Rohan Behel, and Ahemdev get it right. It is money plant. The legend is if you have money plant in your home, money will start multiplying. It hasn't hold true in my case. Yeah.
I'm so sorry to interrupt you, but someone is typing for everyone in the chat box.
Is it? Let me open the chat box.
Rakhi, hello. Sorry to interrupt you, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, Rakhi is actually typing in the chat box. Rakhi, please see that you are typing in privately to sir directly. Please ensure that.
Okay, Rakhi, if you wish to answer, please check a chat box named Anirudh Morarka and write your answers over there instead of writing in public because everybody will be able to read your answers and write their answers. Okay, moving on. Last few questions remain. Once again, requesting you not to Google because again, I'm getting to see a lot of botanical names of money plant which even the Taiwanese farmer might not have known. So please don't Google or I'll be forced to name you. Question number 30. In Kerala, the royal poinciana tree, commonly known as the X, is called Kalvaripu, which means flower of the cavalry. There is a popular belief amongst the St. Thomas Christians that when Jesus Christ was crucified, there was a small royal poinsettia tree nearby his cross. It is believed that the blood of Jesus was shed over the flowers of the tree, and this is how the flowers of the royal poinsettia got its sharp red color. Identify the common name of the royal poinsettia, that is X, also called as Kalvari Poo in Kerala. Red color is the main feature that we have mentioned in this particular question. By what name do we know it now? And we do have three answers. And again, botanical names are not expected. Please give me the normal names. Non-Google names. Okay, the answer is indeed Gulmohar. Three people who get it right are Rabia Shabir, Ayush Kumar Jha, and Rohan Bell. The penultimate question, but before that, we'll check the scores one. Yukta Singh is at 130. Ishan Sarda 80, Priyank Dahage 10, Rohan Behel 160, Rabia Shabir 90, Ahmedev 70, Sanchari Banerjee 50, Ayush Jha 50, Ayush Jha 100, Jaira Joshi 20, Pallavi 50, Om Tajane 10, Romil Mahajan 50, Sukrit 10, Aryan 10, Anuja 20, and Ashwin 10. Moving on, this is the penultimate question of the quiz. It's about a plant. X, the scientific name of which you don't have to Google, I have already provided you the same. Sauciera oblavata is a plant endemic to the Himalayan region and is the state flower of Uttarakhand. The flower's head is purple in color, hidden from the view in layers of yellowish green peppery bracts, thus providing protection from the cold environment. According to Hindu mythology, the flower was created by X on Parvati's request in order to help Lord Shiv place the elephant's head on the body of Lord Ganesh. ID this two-worded flower, which is named after its creator. Its creator is the clue. You have to name the flower. Okay, answers are coming in. Okay, the three people who get it right are Rohan Behel, Yukta Singh, and Ishan Sarda. Plus 10 each, the answer is indeed Brahma Kamal. It was created by Lord Brahm, and it's called Brahma Kamal. And now the last question of this quiz. Number 32. The common basilisk, also known as the X lizard, is a species of lizard in the family Corytaphnidae. The species is endemic to Central America and South America, where it is found near rivers and streams in the rainforest. Due to the capability of the lizard to move its hind limbs at around 5 feet per second, grants the animal an ability that might be considered a superpower even. IDX and name of the ability which has resulted in its name. This lizard called as common basilisk has a particular feature because of its hind legs, and this ability is seen as superhuman, and because of that it is called as X lizard. What is X? And we have three answers, but let's have a look at the answer first. It is indeed Jesus Christ lizard, because it because of its swift movements, we might have an illusion that it walks on a surface of water, which only Jesus could do. And the three people who get it right are Yukta, Ahmedev, and Ayush. Yeah, so that's all. That is the end of the quiz. I'd like to thank Melghat Forest Department for giving us the opportunity. And in future, we'll have an offline version of this quiz if you all like this quiz. That's it. And the result will be announced soon.
Sir, I would like to say something.
Yeah, please.
Sir, it was a very great quiz. Like, we enjoyed a lot. We got to learn a lot from this quiz, actually. And that is the essence of the Wildlife Week. So thank you so much for this quiz.
Thank you so much. Really happy to hear your kind words. And we'll be announcing the results soon.
Nihal would like to say a few words.
Yeah. Actually, we would like to thank Nagpur Quiz Club for organizing such a nice quiz. Even we learned a lot by actually organizing the quiz. Many of the questions were new to us, and even we learned a lot of stuff about the environment. So actually, we are from an organization named TURN, and we run a YouTube channel for children, which basically focuses on environment education. So we would like to share a short clip of our channel. So if you are interested, you can subscribe to this channel. Interesting.
Our channel, so if you want to subscribe to it, we will share the link with you. And the and I would like to share that all the 25 participants will be getting the participation certificates for the quiz. So we will mail the certificates to you. And regarding the top three prize winners, we will contact you personally for the gifts and the certificates. So you will get the certificates and the gifts by the end of 7th of October. So let's wait for the results.